I wish you blessed morning today, dear students. Good morning to everyone. Let me introduce myself. I am Shankar. I am going to discuss about 12th biobotany, chapter 6, principles of ecology, topography factors. We are going to discuss about previous class, ecological factors. Ecological factors, there are the 4 types. The first one is climatic factors. The second one is geographic factors, and third one is topographic factors, and fourth one is biotic factors. There are the 4 factors are involved in ecological factors. So what are the 4 factors are involved in ecological factors? The first one is climatic factors, second one is geographic factors, third one is topographic factors, then fourth one is biotic factors. In previous class we are discussing about in geographic factors. Geographic factors, the soil formation, types of soil, then soil profile, and the last one is soil particles. We are discussing about previous class. Now I am going to discuss about topographic factors. What is a topographic factors? So topographic factors is there abiotic factors. Topographic factors, that is called abiotic factors. These abiotic factors, the study of size, shape, structure, features of earth surface. Are called topographic. What is a topographic factors? A topographic factor means the study of size, shape, structure, features of earth surface. That is called a topographic factors. In earth, the earth surface is sloping under these regions. The height of this earth surface and sweeping of earth surface and plane of earth surface. We can study about only size, shape, structure, features of earth surface. That is called topographic factors. Topographic factors. In these factors, it may be growing. It influences. There are different types of radiations, the different types of solar radiations, and the different types of wind wavelength, and different types of intensity of light is maximum effects of only vegetation growth. It affects of only vegetation growth. It vegetate in climatic condition, it may be changes due to occurs only different types of influences found in only topographic region. It's a topographic zonal region. There are the first the influence of different than climatic factors affect the vegetation growth. Vegetation growth may occur. So what are the different types of climatic factors? Climatics at the, let's say, solar radiations, wind, humidity, rainfall, latitude, and altitudes. These zonal regions, latitude zonal regions, altitude zonal regions, there are different climatic factors. The climatic factors are involved only different types of vegetation growth is may be formed in this only topography factors. It involves only topographic factors. These topographic factors include, there are three types. The first one is latitude and altitudes. The second one is direction of mountain. The next one is steepness. Steepness of mountain. These topographic factors are involved in different types of vegetation growth. It may be occurs only, that's a latitude and altitude zonal regions. The first type. The second type, direction of mountains. There are different types of vegetation may be growth occurs. Next, third one is steepness of mountain growth. There are different types of vegetation growth occurs only in the topographic factors. The next types, there are the three types of includes the topographic factors. The first one is latitude and the altitudes. These latitudes refers to form up only in different types of vegetation growth. Let's say direction of equators. To move forward, different types of vegetation growth is may be occurs only latitudinal regions. This is a latitudinal zones. Zonation is a altitudinal zonations. Is a 0 degree Celsius, that is a equator. The equators to go gradually into different types of vegetation growth is occurs towards to form up only ice pools. Ice polar region. This is the equator polar regions to move to gradually decrease or increase of this only different types of vegetation growth is may be occurs. These are the altitudinal region zonal regions, so maximum found in only ice cap regions. There are the different types of vegetation growth is may be occurs. The first tundra forest, then coniferous forest, tropical grassland forest, the temperatures, grassland forest, temperature forest, tropical rainforest, size cap regions, tundra regions, it's a coniferous forest. Then tropical forest, then temperature forest, and a desert forest. It may be so growth of only the high temperatures occurs. High temperatures. So more than high temperatures will be occurs to form only equator regions. Equator regions to this gradually decrease the low temperatures. This gradually decrease the low temperature towards the form of only in ice cap regions. Ice cap regions, say the high temperatures occurs are increased in only in equator regions. Equator regions means gradually decrease the temperatures. Gradually decrease the temperatures towards the form of only ice cap regions. The different types of vegetation may be growth occurs. There are different types of vegetations. This is near to the ice cap regions to form of only very very low temperatures. Very very low temperatures. Let's say 30 degrees Celsius to then 40 degrees Celsius. Celsius will be occurs only tundra forest. Tundra forest. Very low temperatures occurs only coniferous forest, and then again high temperatures occurs only tropical forest. Then again to form only high temperatures to form only temperature forest region and rainforest region. So mostly in the desert region and rainforest regions, more temperature will be occur only equator region. Equator regions will be gradually reduced in the form of only in ice polar regions. Ice polar region, that's a equator region. That the frosts are involved only, that's a latitude zonal region. This latitude zonal regions will be occurs only high temperatures in equator region and low temperatures occurs only ice cap region. This is a form of only different types of vegetation occurs. What are the different types of vegetation occurs? Tundra forest, coniferous forest, tropical grassland forest, and temperature forest, and tropical rainforest region. These tropical rainforest regions, more temperature and more yield and more vegetation growth occurs. More vegetation growth occurs only in these equator regions. The next one is latitudinal regions. These latitudinal regions, these latitude zonation regions to form up only increase the only wind velocities. Increase wind velocity and light intensity and light durations. Let's say increase the form of only wind velocity and light intensity wavelength, and the light duration will be increase the form of only in the altitudinal regions. These altitudinal regions is above the sea levels. This is a formation of latitudinal zonations. Altitudinal zonations. These altitudinal zonations, the height of sea level. This altitudinal zonation only the height of sea level. This formation of only altitudinal zonation. These altitudinal zonations say more than different types of vegetation growth. Different types of vegetation growth occurs. This topmost region, that is a very very low temperature but high wind velocities. High light intensities, high intensity of wavelength occurs only this region of only high cap region. The next one is tundra region forest, the coniferous forest, say temperature gradient forest and desertous forest and the tropical rainforest. It may be different types of vegetation growth occurs only due to the climatic changes. So what are the climatic changes? So increase the wind velocity and the intensity of light intensities and light duration may be increased. Decrease in the form of only altitudinal zonations. This altitude zonation only decrease the temperatures. So high temperature regions are found in only in this ice cap region. But these reduce of only temperature from this only ice cap zonal region to the sea level. The height of the sea level, that is called altitudinal zonation. This high temperatures will be occurs only ice cap region, but reduce of this only temperature or will be decrease the temperature occurs only then equator region. These are different types of vegetation may be growth occurs only the climatic changes. They increase the wind velocity and light intensity and light duration times will be increase the form up only in altitudinal zonations and then only decrease the only temperature and air pressures. Temperature and air pressures are found in only then altitudinal zonations. So next one is direction of the second topic. Direction of mountains. Direction of mountains. In these north pole and south regions, north and south places. North and south places of the mountain is mountains or hills possess different types of different types of vegetation growth is may be others. There are the north pole and south polar regions of mountains are hills possess the different types of vegetation growth occurs only direction of mountains. Direction of mountains for this only see north polar regions, then south polar regions, then east polar regions, then next one is west polar regions. So north poles and south poles are polar regions. So due to the formation of only sunlight dispersions, only the east polar regions. This opposite the polar region, that is north and the south polar region. North and the south polar regions. These north and south polar regions, north and the south polar regions. Then sir, wind velocity and intensity of wavelength and solar radiations. Solar radiation. That is solar radiations. Solar radiations. Wind velocity. Light intensity, then light durations, then wind velocity, that solar radiation, say wind velocity, say light duration and then light intensities and temperatures. These are climatic changes occurs in only north polar region and south polar regions. This north polar region and south polar regions climatic changes occurs. There are different types of vegetation growth occurs due to the formation of only direction of mountains. This direction of mountains, solar radiation, wind velocity, light intensity, light duration and temperature and air pressure. If these are only increase or decrease the level of only formation of only different types of vegetation growth in only in soil particles. In other than similarly in only aquatic plants, in aquatic region of pond there are different types of let's say epilimnons, that's a thermocline, hypolimnon and benthos. There are different types of zones, there are different types of only regions are found in only in aquatic region of only pond ecosystem. There is a topmost region that is epilimnon and below the region of there is a thermolimnon, that is thermocline variety only due to the temperatures will be very high. So hypolimnon and benthos. There are different types of vegetation growth may be occurs. Different types of vegetation growth may be occurs due to the only climatic conditions. That's a light intensities, air pressure, temperature, water and humidity natures. These are only climatic changes will be occurs only aquatic region of pond ecosystem. It may be growth that there are different types of vegetation growth it may be occurs due to the formation of only direction of mountain. This direction of mountains only soil region, this direction of mountain only aquatic region of the pond ecosystem will be occurs. Then third topic is steepness. Stiffness of the mountains. Stiffness of only in mountains. The steepness of mountains, regions of reference of mountain or hill passes only rain water, rain and runoff waters. The climatic changes will be occurs different types of vegetation growth due to the formation of only rain and runoff waters. Due to changes occurs only different types of vegetation growth. For example, see the formation of only during rainy season clouds. Clouds after coming to the only rain. Rain, the slope of region of the rain to form up only runoff waters. These are only runoff waters. The valley regions and the plain ranges. Valley region and the plains. So runoff waters due to only erosions. It's a soil erosions due to caused by this only due to runoff waters. Very less amount of plants will be growth occurs only steepness regions. Steepness, very less amount of regions, but the plains. And values. So occurs only more vegetative growth. So more vegetation growth occurs only plants and values due to the formation of only rain and runoff waters. The rain and runoff waters due to the form of slopeless regions, this is a form of only due to cost of only soil erosion. Due to cause of only soil erosion, that's there is no stagnant of only water sources. There is no absorption of water sources in these soil particles. So move towards only topper region. That's a topper region to the bottom regions. Due to the cause of only soil erosion. Very less amount of vegetation growth occurs only sloping regions. That's a steepness regions. These are only plains and valley regions more vegetative growth occurs. But this opposite to the region of only, that's a wind velocity due to the rain very less in only. Wind velocity and very less in only rainwater sources, that's a poor vegetation growth. For vegetation growth occurs only opposite direction, that's a shedding of runoff rainwaters is the form of only poor vegetation growth. But where this occurs only rain and where this occurs only runoff waters more, this process occurs only different types of vegetation growth is may be formed. The steepness of the mountain. The steepness of the mountain, reference of this mountain or hill possesses only rain and runoff waters. Based on these conditions, due to the different types of vegetation growth may be occurs. Where it is poor vegetation, where it is only good vegetation occurs. The good vegetation may be occurs only where the more rain and more runoff water regions. But very less in poor vegetation occurs only absence of only rain and absence of only runoff waters where it is occurs. That region occurs only poor vegetation growth. The next topic is biotic factors. Next topic, say biotic factors. The biotic factors are interaction between living things. The interaction between that's a living thing, that is called only biotic factors. That's a plants and animals. plants and animals, see interaction between them. One is harmful, one is benefit, or both are benefited occurs only. See biotic factors. See biotic, bio refers to life, bio refers to two. That's a two. One is plants, the other is animals. The both interaction between the relationship among this found only in biotic factors. These biotic factors are involved in different types of only in climatic changes. Due to formation of only harmful and benefit activities. So both condition will be occurs only in biotic factors. In these biotic factors, there are two different both are benefits and harmful activities condition. One is positive interactions. And second is negative interactions. It will be occurs only in the biotic factors. There are two types of interaction occurs only. One is positive interaction, second is negative interaction. This positive interactions are both are benefits. Let's say both are benefits. There are the two types of positive interactions. Let's say mutualisms. Then second is commensalisms. Mutualism and commensalism. And negative interaction will be occurs only. There are the four types. The first one is viridations. The second types parasitism. Then third types competitions. And fourth types amensalisms. There are the four types of will be occurs only. Say negative interactions. So positive interaction is both are benefit or one is harmed. Neither harmful. That's the first mutualisms. So both are benefits. One species plant, another species animals. Either one species plants, another species also plants. So both are mutual benefit occurs only mutualisms. Both are benefits occurs only mutual. But commensalisms. So one is benefits. One is armed or neither harmful activities, neither benefits or not armed condition. That's a form of only commensalisms. But one is benefit, the another also benefit. That's a both are mutual benefits occurs only mutualism. It's a fast interaction. It's a commensalism. Next topic is commensalism. The commensalism one is one species a benefit. Say another species that is a neither unaffected conditions. So pediatricians. One is armed, also armed conditions. So both are only unaffected conditions. Pediatrician and parasites also both are only unaffected conditions. Let's say both are not benefited but unarmed conditions. Occurs only competition. So next one is both are only negative interaction and negative interactions. Salmon cells also negative interaction and unaffected conditions. These are the four types of only biotic factors. The first will be discussed about only positive interaction in mutualism. Positive interaction and mutualisms. First one is mutualisms. The other will be occurs two species. So both are benefits. So both are benefits occurs only mutualisms. So one species of plants, another species of plants, and that's a both are benefit occurs only in living organisms. That's a mutual benefit occurs only mutualism. That's it's only positive interaction. That's a both are benefits. Both are only benefits. That's a mutual relationship occurs only this type of positive interaction. For examples in rhizobium. So rhizobium is a kind of bacteria. This rhizobium bacteria found in only root nodules. Root nodules, this type of only epidermal lesions. These are only root, root tip and root nodules. These are found in only root nodules are found in only bacteria. These are isobutyl kinds of bacteria. This bacteria found in only root nodules of only leguminous plants. These are found in only leguminous plants. So leguminous is a kind of plant organism. The rhizobium is a kind of bacteria. This bacteria found in only root nodules of only leguminous plants. This bacteria absorbs only food sources in only in plants. Food absorbed from only in plants. This type of bacteria. But this type of bacteria due to the formation of only nitrogen fixations. Nitrogen fixation. The atmosphere free nitrogen. Free nitrogen fixed to the form of only to convert the form of only nitrate and ammonia. This ammonia are used only in the use way only in green plants. That's a leguminous plants. These leguminous plants utilize the ammonia to convert the form of only food. The food sources in this from this only in leguminous plants. These food are utilized only in bacteria. These are both benefited. So bacteria found in only root nodules of leguminous plants. Root nodules of leguminous plants. This type of bacteria absorb the food from this food from only in leguminous plant. This type of bacteria fixing the atmosphere nitrogen. Fixing the atmosphere nitrogen. This atmosphere nitrogen to convert to form only nitrate. To convert to form only nitrate. So other example of only in the mutual benefits and positive interaction. For examples, Nasdaq. Nasdaq is a founding only cyanobacteria. This Nasdaq found in only in Andosaurus. Andosaurus. The next one is Asola. The Sarnabina Asolas are found in only coralloid roots of Cycas. Coralloid roots of only Cycas. Nasdaq, Andosaurus, some types of mycorrhizal. Mycorrhizal fungi. The mycorrhizal fungus are root inhabiting fungus. Root inhabiting fungus and Asola, Anabina Asola, Nasdaq, this type of bacteria, this type of organism, both are benefit activities. Both are only benefit activities. That type of organism also called say, positive interactions, mutualisms. Positive interaction, mutualism. The best example sources, the first one is rhizobium, the second one is Nasdaq, and third one is Asola, Anabina Asola, and fourth one is mycorrhizal roots. Mycorrhizal fungus. Mycorrhizal fungus. So next topic is common salicylates. The next topic is only positive interactions, common salicylates. The first interaction may be two types. The first one is mutualism, second one is only common salicylates. The second one is common salicylates. These are common salicylates are the two organisms. So one is benefits. One is benefits. So another species. Neither benefits or nor are unaffected. Or no. What is a common salicylism? So common salicylism are one of the two organisms. These two organisms, one organism benefits, so another types of species neither benefits or not armed or unaffected conditions. Or unaffected. Unaffected. Unaffected condition. These are involved only common salicylisms. These are not only common salicylisms. For examples, epiphytic plants. Epiphytic plants in examples in Vanda. Epiphytic plants in examples in Vanda. For examples, these are only in bark regions. The worst plants. leaves, host plants, clinging roots, let's say aerial roots. Clinging roots and aerial roots. This type of bond are fixed in the host plants. This is a host plant. It's a parasitic mode of nutrition circus. This type of only chymatization process. This type of only in Vanda, the fixed only host plants. There are two types of roots are found in only in Vanda. The first one is clinging roots. The second is aerial roots. The clinging roots fix the host plants. This absorption of only the food sources. Absorption only the food sources, the host plants. But aerial roots are found in only surface of area, absorption of moist airs. The atmosphere free moist airs, absorption of only aerial roots. These are only food media, absorption of water, and they can synthesize only green leaves, perform the photosynthesis process. But these host plants cannot synthesize the food material. So without the chlorophyll pigments, they cannot synthesize the host plant, host material, host organism does not synthesize only food material. This synthesis of food material to absorb the only food sources only in Vanda. Vanda plants support the host plants. These host plants absorption of nutrition from this only eat this epiphytic plants. There are two types of roots are found in only in Vanda: clinging roots and aerial roots. This aerial roots are found in only special type of tissue. Special types of tissue are found in. So one is vellum. It's a vellum tissue are found in only aerial roots. These types of vellum tissue possess only in chlorophyll pigments. These vellum tissue possess only chlorophyll pigments. They can synthesize only food material. This common solution. These are only benefits. These Vanda plants are benefits from this only the host plants. Supporting to these only host plants. They can absorb the only atmosphere moist air from this only aerial roots. They synthesize only food material in Vanda. After this food material absorbs the only the host plants. These are only epiphytic plants. These are found in only orchids plants. First example source of only orchids in Vanda. In this class, we are discussing about topographic factors. What is topographic factors? So, how many types of includes these topographic factors? There are three types of only topographic factors. The first one is altitude and latitudinal regions. The second one is direction of mountains, and third one is steepness of mountain. Next one is biotic factors. The biotic factors interaction between the both benefit activities. Both benefit activities, the both living organisms, that is called a biotic relationship, mode of interaction. The first, there are two types of only biotic factors, positive interaction and negative interactions. And we will pass on the next class. Okay, thank you.